I tried the application on iPad and I was blown away. Even without any 3D design background, I loved how intuitive the application was. I told my wife that it would be awesome if I could work here, and now here I am. And I'm still loving it, learning every day, both professionally and in this world of CAD.
My name is Daniel. I have been working at Shapr for the past 3 years. I just completed my third one on the core modeling team. Still a lot of coding, obviously, I'm an engineer, but increasingly I'm also working on planning ahead and trying to figure out what brings the most value to customers of Shapr. The language that we use in my job, this is mostly C++, so that's my main language that I use. We also tend to work a bit in Swift or C Sharp. Those are the native UI languages that we use.
My name is Chongor Sabo, and I'm the director of engineering at Shapr for the core modeling teams. We are responsible for developing the core stack for the 3D modeling and also for industrial drawings and sketching experience.
I'm Richie from the same team. I work here at Shapr as a software engineer. Our job is to get things to the Shapr3D cloud. So whenever you start something on your desktop computer, designing something, you stop your job and want to continue on iPad, then your project is available and you can continue where you left. This sounds quite easy, but things can go wrong in many ways. And we are learning a lot from the issues that we face in the wild.
The team that I have been working on in the past couple of years is responsible for multiple features. It's responsible for the drawings feature of Shapr, and then it's responsible for a couple of tools within Shapr. For example, such a tool is the pattern tool, which is entirely developed by the team that I'm working on. Also, the measurements feature was one that I participated in, and I think it's turned out quite well.
It's challenging to build up this technology from bottom up and kind of having also advantage over these big mammoth companies who were developing these softwares for 20, 30 years. So there is plenty room for innovation and new approaches, and that's kind of exciting.
I'd like to highlight one thing from a few months back where we worked on the version history of Shapr, where you can select previous versions of your project and go back to that one. And the first milestone of that was done by coming together and coding until we have something working. And it was very good because each of us had the same understanding of the basics of this new solution. And of course, we were happy that we have something working that was waited for a long time from our customers.
It's a great place because the moment you start contributing to Shapr, you realize that you have a high impact on not only on the code base, but on the product and the users themselves. There is no politics, no bureaucracy around it. So we highly encourage everybody to have their own projects or their own ideas and try them out and show them off for everybody.
Since Shapr3D is like a 3D modeling application, by nature, it's pretty complex. And all that complexity needs to be resolved and presented to users in a way that makes sense and that's seemingly simple and intuitive and easy to use. This is not an easy process. It takes a lot of iteration, it takes a lot of work, it takes a lot of thought. And this kind of work is rare to find.
I think somebody who tries at Shapr is really curious. It's really engaged, and you need to have a kind of resilience because, as I said, many things are changing, so you have to be able to adapt really fast to it. You can be one source of these kind of changes.
We get a lot of support, both from other engineers and managers as well. So I feel like in the 3 years that I have been here, I learned both professionally and personally an immense amount of things that I don't think I could have learned anywhere else.
In my early days here at Shapr, Akos, our CTO, was my manager. I really loved the one-on-ones with him. I learned a ton from those discussions. For example, when we discussed leadership values, how we think about leadership and about responsibility, that even if something is not formally part of my job, but I can help with that, and I'm gonna do that.